Good morning, students. Welcome to the History and Civics class of class 7th. We were doing lesson number 10 of history. The name of the lesson is Jahangir and Shah Jahan. Topics to be discussed in this lesson are number 1, introduction, number 2, Jahangir and his military campaign, number 3, Nur Jahan, number 4, arrival of East India Company, number 5, estimate of Jahangir, number 6, Shah Jahan and his military campaign, number 7, cultural developments under Shah Jahan, number 8, estimate of Shah Jahan. Students, let's discuss the new words of today's topic. Number 1, patronize means support. Number 2, symmetry, sequence. Number 3, awesome, it means extremely impressive. Number 4, petrodura, a style of ornamentation where semi-precious stones are embedded in marble. Number 5, zenith, it means highest point of success. Number 6, high and dry, it means in a difficult situation. Before starting with today's topic, let us recall the cross questions of previous day topic. Number 1, which Mughal emperor occupied throne after Jahangir? Number 2, what is the original name of Mumtaz Mahal? Number 3, what is the meaning of the word Mumtaz Mahal? Number 4, name the monument built by Shah Jahan in the memory of Mumtaz. Number 5, name the sons of Shah Jahan. Number 6, was Shah Jahan successful in the Deccan campaign? Number 7, where was Shah Jahan buried? Students, you have to take out page number 105. Cultural developments under Shah Jahan. The reign of Shah Jahan has been described as the golden age in the history of medieval India. He patronized literature, architecture and painting. By the word patronized, we mean support. It means Shah Jahan supported literature, architecture and paintings. Literature, it means writing in a specific language. Along with Persian, Shah Jahan was a great patron of Hindi literature. The greatest poets and authors of his reign were number 1, Jagannath Pandit, number 2, Sundar Das. Jagannath Pandit was the author of Ras Gangadhar and Ganga Lehri. Number 2, Sundar Das. He was the author of Sihasan Patisi and Sundar Shingar. Sundar Das was given the title of Mahakavi Rai. Our next topic is architecture. The reign of Shah Jahan is particularly famous for the excellent work done in the field of architecture during his reign. His marvelous buildings represent the peak of the Mughal architecture in India. By the word marvelous, we mean extremely beautiful. His extremely beautiful buildings represent the peak of the Mughal architecture in India. He is known as the engineer emperor. Students, here the question rises, why Shah Jahan was known as the engineer emperor? As he is particularly famous for the excellent work done in the field of architecture during his reign. Also, his marvelous buildings represent the peak of the Mughal architecture in India. The most famous monuments constructed by Shah Jahan are, here the word monuments means historical buildings. Number 1, the Taj Mahal at Agra, Shah Jahanabad, the Red Fort, and the Jama Masjid at Delhi and Jahangir's tomb at Lahore. The buildings of Shah Jahan's period are extremely beautiful with perfect symmetry of design. Symmetry means sequence. The buildings were extremely beautiful with the perfect sequence of design. The beautiful expression of feelings in stone is awesome or impressive. The Taj Mahal built in the memory of Mumtaz Mahal is one of the finest buildings in the world. It is absolutely flawless in design and execution. It has been aptly characterized as a lyric in stone. By the word aptly, we mean appropriately, and lyric means direct feeling. It means the Taj Mahal is appropriately characterized as a direct feeling of Shah Jahan in stone. The use of Petrodura has been done to its ultimate perfection. The Taj Mahal is an unforgettable dream in marble. Students, Petrodura is a style of ornamentation where semi-precious stones are embedded in marble. Our next topic is painting. Shah Jahan had lukewarm passion for painting. Here the word lukewarm, we mean little interest. Shah Jahan had little interest in painting. His devotion to architecture discouraged painting. Consequently, means end result, several painters were dismissed from the royal court and the craft of painters was also declined. Next is music. Shah Jahan was a great patron and lover of music. He listened to music every evening. He also patronized musicians. Our next topic is Shah Jahan's estimate. By the word estimate, we mean to make opinion regarding the worth. Shah Jahan's reign is the golden age of the Mughal Empire. It was politically united, economically prosperous, and culturally vibrant. There was law and order, peace and security in the country, and no foreign invasions, means no foreign attacks. Shah Jahan's reign witnessed the full flowering of architecture. The magnificence of the monuments built by Shah Jahan is the one of the most enduring characteristics of his reign. Painters, scholars, and magicians were also patronized by the emperor. The policy of religious tolerance and friendship with the Rajputs was continued by Shah Jahan. Estimate of Shah Jahan. Shah Jahan was an able ruler and administrator. Some of the military campaigns undertaken by him resulted in a failure. His life symbolizes striking contrast of good and the bad fortunes. He was learned and fond of literature. He gave due patronage to Persian and Hindi literature. His reign marked the zenith of the medieval Indian architecture. Zenith means highest point. His reign marked the highest point of the medieval Indian architecture. He also extended patronage to music and painting. But the excessive building projects of Shah Jahan hit hard on the state treasury. Here the word treasury means wealth. Therefore, he raised the state demand from 33% to 50% of the gross produce. This subsequently increased the burden on the peasants. Peasants means farmers. Shah Jahan's devotion to architecture hit hard on the state wealth. Therefore, he raised the tax from 33% to 50% of the gross produce. This increased the burden on the farmers. However, the war of succession among his four sons extracted the vitality of empire. By the word vitality, we mean strength, and left the emperor high and dry. It means it left the emperor in a difficult situation that who is going to be the next successor. Students, do you know the Taj Mahal stands on the southern bank of the Yamuna River in Agra? The Mughal Emperor Shah Jahan commissioned it in AD 1631. The construction of the Taj Mahal was entrusted to a board of architects by Shah Jahan. Thousands of artisans and craftsmen were employed to build this outstanding example of Mughal architecture. It combines Indian, Persian, and Islamic architectural styles. In 1883, the UNESCO designated Taj Mahal as a World Heritage Site. With this, we have completed our chapter Jahangir and Shah Jahan. I hope you all have completed your exercises side by side. Thank you and have a nice day.